everyone. Today I'm in Oakville. Behind me is Driver Examination Center. And today we're doing G full road test. We're gonna do the mock-up exam, take you on an actual route, and give you all the tips and tricks you need to pass your road test from the first time.
Now I recommend you to park backwards like this. So when you start your road test, you just go straight, you turn right, and you're on your way.
All right, so here we are in the car. We've registered inside, and now we are waiting for our examinator to show up. I'm here today with my friend and an expert in this field, and he's gonna help us with this mock-up exam.
Hi everyone. So before the road test, examiner will come to you, to your car, to your where you're waiting in the parking spot, and he just ask you to start your car, roll down the window, and they want to verify your ID and ask you what's your name, what's your date of birth, what's your address, make sure you know your postal code. And then he goes around your car to make a circle check to make sure all lights are working in properly, and check signal left, signal right, brake lights, make sure you have good tires on your car, and make sure you have no windshield cracks, and honk the horn. Then he sit down inside your car and ask you to sign the papers. Before it was papers, right now it's iPads. And then you start your road test. So make sure you check your all blind spots, make sure you check in your rear view every 5 to 10 seconds, and you're making signals, and speed limit should be over control all the time. And yeah.
If you have a windshield crack, would the exam be canceled?
Yeah, exam not gonna happen if you have a windshield crack. If you have bad tires, if your signal left or one of the brake lights doesn't work, so it's not gonna happen. So make sure you have all this in proper condition.
And then can you rent a car?
Yeah, you can rent a car. You can use a rental car, you can use your friend's car, your family, like dad's, mom's car, like doesn't matter. But like if you're coming for the G2 road test, make sure you have a second person, because if you fail, examiner will ask you who's gonna drive you home, so they want to see the second person accommodating you.
Mm-hmm. And today we have sunny skies.
Yeah,
is it okay to wear sunglasses or ask them?
My recommendation to you, don't use the sunglasses for the road test unless it's prescribed, because examiners, they want to see your eyes, how you move your eyes, how you check in your rear view, how you check in your blind spot. So they want to see your eyes. So during the exam, it's like 10-12 minutes, maybe 15 minutes you're gonna survive without glasses. So my recommendation to you, don't use the sunglasses.
And if it's bad weather, would like in the winter or heavy rain, would it be canceled?
Yeah, if it's icy road or too much snow on the road test usually canceled or rescheduled. Mm-hmm. But if it's heavy rain, it's gonna be road test still. It's not happen. Gonna be canceled. Yeah. So if you have bad weather conditions and road conditions, you drive as you feel safe.
For example, you don't have to go 50, 60,
yeah, whatever. For example, speed limit is 50 and too much water on the road, you drive as it's safe, 30, 40, as you feel safe. The main idea of the road test is safety.
Mm-hmm. And if it's raining or if it's snowing, you want to know where all the controls are in the car.
Yeah.
So you know how to turn on the windshield wipers, how to defrost your windows, make sure if it's winter that you don't have snow.
How to defog your windows. Yeah, you should know all this stuff in your car or in the car you use for the road tests.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay.
And if there is a big line, we don't wait. We just
go inside. You have a road test appointment, don't wait in line. Right now we have COVID-19 situation. It's like big line to enter the road test center. But if you have road test appointment, just go straight to the door and there is the person. And you say, okay, I have a road test appointment today. And it's like they let you in without any waiting in line.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. So then we buckle up.
Yeah. Don't forget to buckle up and start your car. And let's go through the route.
Okay, starting the car, buckled up.
Okay, if you're ready, let's go to the right.
Okay, hand brake, put on D.
So we're exiting from here, from signal, this plaza.
Signal right.
This is a busy plaza. Make sure you see all these pedestrians and cars, and it's a place of excitement, and sometimes people just running across of the road, like under the wheels of your car. Here we have no stop sign, but make sure it's no cars.
Mm-hmm.
And from exiting we here, we're turning right to the Wycroft.
And this is the second route.
Yeah.
Okay.
Route number 2 for G full.
There, it's a busy examination center, so there's two routes for G full.
And two routes for G 2. So right now it's a G full second route. And speed limit on Wycroft is 50. It's one line for us, one line for incoming traffic. And we're gonna go toward the third lane line. Yeah, when you're crossing intersections, you're checking left, right, left. You have to check your rear view every 5 to 10 seconds. And your speed limit should be under control all the time. So your G full road test, it consists in two parts. One part is the city driving, another one is the highway driving. On the city part, examiner will ask you to make a 3-point turn. Parallel parking and roadside stop. When you use your four-way signal or emergency button, make sure you know where is the button in your car. And the highway part is gonna be on a highway 403. And you enter in highway 2 times and you exit in highway 2 times. And on the highway is three main ideas, is entering and merging to traffic, changing lane, and exiting from a highway. So here we're turning left on the third line. It's two lanes turning left. You can make it left in any lane.
And there's an arrow, green arrow.
Green arrow is good. If you turn into the second lane, staying in the second lane. If you turn in the left lane, then you have to switch to the right. So we keep going straight. We're not entering highway right now. We're going to the residential area. And when you're crossing intersections, you're checking left, right, left, not only for cars, but also for pedestrians.
Street, so
yeah, third line is 60? One of the major streets. Speed limit is 60. If you have chance to go 60, speed up till 60. If all traffic flow in front of you going slowly, you keep this traffic flow speed.
And as you slow down, check the
rear view
mirror.
Yeah, and when you check in your rear view, exaggerate a little bit. We recommend chin up, then examiner
can see
for sure that like you're checking your rear view. And formula, mirror, signal, blind spot. Before you're making any maneuvers, any turns, check your mirror, make a signal, and blind check spot. Your blind spot or over shoulder check. Crossing intersections, left, right, left. traffic light, we're turning right. Oakville Drive.
Okay. Blind spot.
Here we have pedestrian line.
Bicycle.
Oh, line for bicyclists. And we wanna leave this line for bicyclists free. And we're gonna make a left turn to the Pilgrim Crescent.
And here we suppose the speed limit is 50.
Yeah.
Because we didn't.
If you have no speed limit signs, you suppose it's 50. So if you have chance to go 50, go 50.
Okay, and here we turn left.
Turn left. We have a special lane for left turn. Always stop. So make sure it's a full stop.
Okay,
first
check
come,
left,
first
right,
go.
Left.
Yep.
School bus.
School bus.
Turn into your lane.
Yeah. Again, speed limit is 50. We're going straight and leave this lane for bicyclists free. When you're making a right turn, make sure it's no bicyclists.
Here,
so
40.
Here we have school zone 40. So examiners want you to go through the school zone. And when you're driving at school zone, keep your speed limit under control all the time.
Mm-hmm. Check for pedestrians, bicyclists.
Bicyclists.
Watch out for bicycles.
Yeah. Checking left, right when you're crossing intersections.
Okay, maintain 40.
Maintain 40.
It's really easy to speed here.
Yeah.
Okay. And then 50 begins.
50 begins, no school zone anymore. Stop, first come, first go. Again, speed limit sign is 50. Sometimes we have bicyclists, sometimes rollerbladers on this. Another always stop. First come, first go. Next intersection, we're gonna turn right.
Okay, maintaining 50.
Maintaining 50, and this one we're turning right. It's a Wind Rush Drive. Okay, so examiner will ask you to make a 3-point turn, parallel parking, and roadside stop. Okay, pull over to the right and park your car, like let's make a roadside stop.
Okay, I'm not gonna block the roadways.
Yep.
Park it here, put on P, handbrake, emergency signal, four-way signal on, foot off the brake and turn wheels to the right because it looks like it's kind of going downhill or flat road.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, let's get out from here.
Okay, so when is it? It's most of the time it's to the right.
Yep, it's a downhill with the curb to the right. The only one way left is like uphill with the curb. If it's flat road, just turn the wheels to the right towards the curb.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Handbrake, put on D, make the wheels straight. Don't forget to
off
turn
your
off
four-way
signal. turn show signal left, mirror signal, blind spot, and we're getting out.
Okay. Parallel parking with this car,
The black one there.
Yep. Make sure you practice parallel parking a lot with different cars, with a minivan, pickup truck, and SUV, because you don't know what it's gonna be on the road test.
Okay. Show signal.
The main idea, don't touch the curb. We have a special video on this one, how to make a parallel parking perfect. You can practice and make it perfect in maybe in 20 minutes, but you have to practice it with different cars. So make sure you check it out.
Handbrake, wheels to the right, looks like flat road.
Okay.
And that's it.
That's it. Okay, let's get out from here. So sometimes examiners, they open the door to check the distance between your car and the curb. Ideal distance is 1 foot, is about 30 centimeters. Don't be freaked out, they're just having fun.
Mm-hmm.
They just open the door to check if it's right. Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
Let's get out.
Handbrake, put on rear. I'm gonna back out a little bit, make the wheel straight, show signal left. Out a little bit here.
The main idea, you don't want to touch the curb with the
put on D, mirror signal, blind spot. Okay,
and
40 is here, so
yeah,
watch the speed signs.
And let's make a 3-point turn right here. The same idea with the 3-point turn, you don't want to touch the curb with your wheels, and your 3-point turn should be in between two curbs. Don't use the driveways.
Signal left.
Make sure no cars in front, no cars approaching from behind.
Signal
if you
right.
Have some cars, wait.
Going back, looking back, not touching any curb. Put on D, signal left. Wheels all the way left.
Okay.
Getting out. So here I gained 40.
40 begins here. And as soon as you made a 3-point turn, from this point you're going back the same streets, and your city part is practically done. So you made already 3-point turn, parallel parking, and roadside stop or emergency stop. And right now you're going to the highway.
Okay, keeping 40.
Keeping 40. And we're going back to Pilgrim. And this stop sign, we're turning left. Pilgrim's Way, and this stop sign is only for us, and we have stop line. Make sure it's a full stop, 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, and then yeah, we're turning left. Make sure it's no cars from the left and right, because this stop sign is only for us.
Mm-hmm.
If you cannot see or observe, like, you can advance a little bit.
And if you have your lane, don't turn into bike lane.
Yeah. Leave this bike lane free. Okay.
Here, assuming it's 50.
Yep. And always stop for going straight.
1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi.
We're going back to Abbeywood. This is calm residential area, it's practically no traffic at all. But sometimes we have pedestrians, sometimes we have school buses, and sometimes we have kids here, so...
There's a school bus.
You pay attention. Okay. Another always stop. Who came first, go first. Okay. Speed limit is changing by 50 right here, so we have no school zone anymore. And we're going back to Abbeywood, and we're gonna make a right turn on Abbeywood. So if you have pedestrians, slow down for them, let them cross the road.
40 begins here.
40 begins here again. Another school zone.
School crossing, so you want to stop for pedestrians here?
Yeah, if you have pedestrians. Sometimes we have a crossing guards here, so you pay attention, especially when school zone is when school is finished after 3 p.m. or in the morning. Yeah, 50 begins here, no school zone anymore. And this coming stop sign, we're turning right. Abbeywood Drive. First come, first go. You're checking for pedestrians, you're checking your blind spots. Third line is the major street in here in Oakville. Speed limit on third line is 60. And again, if you have no speed limit signs, you suppose it's 50 by default. Mm-hmm. And this coming traffic light, gonna turn left, third line,
green light, so advance to the middle of intersection, check for pedestrians, turn into the left lane,
okay,
automatically switch to the right,
switch your lane to the right, and we're gonna be enter highway 403 toward west, toward Hamilton. And speed limit on 403 is 100 kilometers per hour, so you have to accelerate pretty energetic.
Okay, going west, showing signal.
Okay, here we have recommended speed for the curve.
50, okay.
It's 50, so plus 10 from this recommended speed is gonna be good speed. So if all traffic flow is going slowly, you don't need to accelerate till 100, you accelerate till traffic flow speed to merge. Mm-hmm. But if highway is free, then you have to accelerate pretty energetic till 100 and merge.
So I'm going 80 right now and it looks like traffic is
flow is even going even slowly. Make a signal in advance.
Show signal, yeah.
To let all these cars know that you're gonna be enter.
Okay, and I'm gonna merge here.
Okay, this is good.
Looks like we're going like 60 here.
Yeah. And then examiner will ask you to make a lane change to the right. Gonna be exit to Bronte Road. If it's free highway, probably examiner will ask you to make a lane change to the left and right. But right here is right now is pretty heavy traffic. So
and we're exiting on this one.
We're exiting to Bronte Road and then we're turning. So it's a good idea. So we're exiting, yeah. recommended is 60, you're slowing down, and let's make a left turn from the left lane.
From the left lane?
Yep. It's a good idea to be in the left lane, because we're gonna go under the bridge and we're gonna enter highway 403 again toward Toronto right now, and entrance to the highway from the left side. So if you turn from the second lane, then you have to switch your lane to the left. We don't want to make unnecessary maneuvers, so
it's a good idea
to be in the left
father's lane.
Okay. And stay in this lane, and examiner say, okay, we're gonna be enter highway 403 toward Toronto, and we have a special lane for this entrance to 403 east right now toward Toronto. So if you have green arrow as we have right now, is good. If not, then you have to wait for incoming traffic and then you turn. But usually we have a green arrow right here.
Okay. It's good for about 6 cars here, so.
Yeah, and it's a recommended speed on this curve 40. So if you have free road plus 10 from this recommended speed.
Mm-hmm. And again, main idea is to accelerate energetically to 100.
And merge to highlight. This eastbound is going pretty good.
Okay, so here everyone accelerates, show signal.
Yep.
Okay, accelerating to 100. And I'm at 100, so
merge. Okay, change your lane left, please, if it's safe. Make a lane change to the right if it's safe. Let's make one more to the right if it's safe. Okay, and we're exiting from highway 403 to third line. When you pass this node third line with a yellow strip at the bottom, then you start slowing down, and recommended speed on this exit is 60, so you're slowing down till 80, 70, 60.
Mm-hmm.
And this coming traffic light, we're turning right.
This
right lane.
Yeah.
Full stop on red. And if it's no cars from the left, so both lanes should be free, should be completely no traffic from the left, you can make a right turn on red signal.
Okay, one more car. And we're good. Check for blind spots.
Okay. And
we're turning
to the right, Wycroft, and we're going back to our examination center.
Wycroft road for us, so just check for pedestrians, bicycles, whatever.
Our lane is ending right now,
so automatically
you have to switch to the left, and speed limit is 50. And we're going back to examination center, and examiner will ask you to make a front-end parking or reverse parking. So make sure you practice reverse parking a lot, because it's last exercise on the road test, last sync on the road test, and if it's if you can perform it like perfectly, it's gonna be good. So we have a special video how to learn how to make a reverse parking. Check it out and practice it on both sides, on the left and on the right, because you don't know, there is a pretty busy plaza and sometimes it's hard to find a place for parking, and examiner will ask you to make a parking on any free spot. And so we're gonna enter
from the right side.
From the end up to the left.
From the other side of the.
It's probably gonna be one entrance before the way you went out from there. So it's right here. It's Autotronics Auto Repairs. It's kind of like from here,
mm-hmm.
And here we turn into the right. Okay. Again, it's a pretty busy plaza. Sometimes we have pedestrians, any cars are parking. And examiner will see you exactly where to park. They like to park to the right side. Okay, let's make a reverse parking beside this red car.
Mm-hmm. That's place number
13.
Oh, how lucky.
It's a good idea if you can make it from the like first shot, but you can go back and forth to fix your position. Your car should be in between two lanes and you have to have enough distance and room to get out from the car for you for examiner. So off your P, engine,
put on P, handbrake, turn off the car.
And at this point examiner say you're okay, congratulations, you pass the road test. Go to the counter, get your temporary G-Full license, and you're gonna get new plastic card through the mail in 2 or 3 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So that's it.
So this was one of the routes.
Yeah,
and
it's
like we mentioned, there's actually two routes. So if you're doing G-Full here, check out the other video for the second route, because you can potentially go left as you exit this parking lot here.
Yeah, you can go left or right, and it's two different routes, so check them both, and it's a good idea to practice them, both of them, if you want to pass it.
Mm-hmm.
And to be familiar with these routes, and it's a good idea to come here in the day of the road test, to come here earlier, maybe 1 hour before, and go through these routes to warm you up, to calm down your nerves, and then you're gonna go for registration.
You'll feel more confident, and you'll know if maybe there's construction or something on the road, you'll know what to expect. So that's definitely a good idea.
Yeah.
What are some of the ways people fail G-Full here?
Most common mistakes, it's usually that's interesting. Even if it's a highway test, most people fail in the city area.
Mm.
And most common mistakes, it's they didn't make a full stop on the stop signs. It's called rolling. So make sure you make a full stop, like 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, no movement at all, full stop on the stop sign.
Mm-hmm.
Second one, when you're making 3-point turn or parallel parking, you touch the curb, and don't touch the curb, no matter what, just fix your position if you go into the curb. And another one is overspeeding. Here we have a school zone, and speed limit is 40, your speed limit should be under control all the time. And if you accelerate till 50, plus 10 from the posted speed limit sign, is going to be a huge mistake.
So even here, when you're exiting highway, you've been going 100, and then you exit third line, you turn into this Wycroft street,
and it's 50, and it's 50, seems to be too slow.
Yeah,
but like, yeah, keep your speed 50, don't be in rush, don't because people want to go through this test as soon as possible, like very quickly, but don't be in a rush, just take your time. Main idea of the road test is safety.
Okay, we saw some school buses there, so if they're stopped and they're flashing their stoplights and
flashing lights.
Those
20 meters before the school bus until the school bus like close the doors and off the flashing or emergency lights.
You just stay 20 meters back and
it doesn't matter school bus on your side of the road or opposite side of the road, all roads, all traffic stops just for kids. And another one, police, firefighters, ambulance. If you have firefighters approaching your car in front or behind, it doesn't matter. So you have to pull over to the right and stop your car and wait for them to pass. And don't follow them less than 150 meters. And usually when the firefighters came, it's like 30 seconds after or 1 minute after, it's gonna be ambulance and then police. So, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Be prepared for this one. Mm-hmm. Another one right now is nice weather and fall time, but winter is approaching really fast. And if you have road conditions not so good, heavy rain or snow, you can drive as you feel comfortable. If speed limit is 50 and it's like road conditions not so good, you drive slowly as you feel safe.
Mm-hmm.
Another one good idea in winter time to remove your winter jacket that you feel comfortable and more free.
Warm up the car
inside. You have to know how to operate your defroster or defog your windows and
put on seat warmer for examining.
Yeah.
A massage chair.
No.
Yeah. But the idea is you want it to be comfortable in the car. You will definitely want to know where everything is, so you can operate it. Like in when it rains, you have foggy windows, and you want to know like how to turn on ventilation. And if you don't know it because it's a rental car, you board a friend's car, you're gonna be panicking. You're like, where do I turn it on? Right. So
yeah,
that's just, you don't want to do that prior. You want to figure things out prior to exam.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's another one. Best time for the highway road test, it's my opinion. It's like after morning rush hour traffic coming down. It's usually after 9 o'clock in the morning. So my favorite time is 9:30, 10:30, 11:50. It's less cars on the road and you can make lane changes very easily, and you can merge on the traffic easily when it's less traffic on the road.
Mm-hmm.
After 3 p.m. it's already afternoon rush hour starting, and it's traffic level is going up, much more traffic on the road.
Mm-hmm. Okay. We hope you found this useful. If you did, please like this video. It will help other people discover it. If we didn't answer your question, or if you have a question that we didn't cover, please write them in the comments below. I'll make sure to get back to you.
Mm-hmm.
And
another one tip for you. Before the road test, they ask you like for declaration, like how many times you were on the highways before. So we have two kinds of highways: highways 80 series and highway 400 series, where the maximum speed limit is 100 kilometers per hour. We recommend our students to make a declaration like, I've been on the highways for the last 3 months more than 100 times. So you practically be on the highway every day. And more than 15 kilometers you travel on the highway. Not only you enter and it was first exit, but you travel more than 15 kilometers on the highway. You made some lane changes, road speed adjustments, and you have experience to drive on the highways. It's not your first or 10th time you enter in highway and you practice this highway only with your driving instructor. So make sure you practice a lot. So if you declare, if your declaration 100 times, it's a good idea you've been on these highways 100 times. You feel you have to be like comfortable on the highways before mm-hmm. you go for the G full road test.
Okay, don't say it's my, I never drove, it's my first time.
Yeah, don't say, don't be nervous, practice a lot, and you feel confident, comfortable, yeah, and then you pass the road test.
Mm-hmm.
So we wish you best yeah. of luck.
Best of luck. Share your experience. We would be curious to know how it went for you, if you passed, which route you took. And that's it. Thank you for watching.
Subscribe. Ring the bell. Yeah. Let us know which route you've been.
Yeah.
Yeah, you did on the highway test.
Okay. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.